can search out their oil light bearings. You can see the oil coming out of the bearing as I grind it down. Now for anybody that's new to what we're doing here, that little port right there leads down to the section of the keel that now has all the lead in it. And the diesel is just to displace oxygen, and we were going to put some glycol in there too. Anything to mix with the water to stop the water from becoming an electrolysis problem. It wouldn't be a huge problem, but it would be a little bit of one. The rest of this tank will be diesel fuel, and a little bit of diesel in it now does the same thing, it displaces the oxygen.
And these plastic plugs on these hatches will be our inspection ports, so we can get down there and take a look, vacuum out any water we might see and biological buildup on the diesel. And then we'll also have to come back in here and to a couple of these hatches, one for each tank. We'll have to add a vent, so when the diesel's flowing in, we're just going to use the suction pipes as the fill pipes are all 1.25 inches. But as the diesel's flowing in or out, it needs to breathe the tank, so we'll put a small probably a 1/2 inch hose running from these tanks up the main mast to the vent. Adapt and overcome. Boy, that's true. All right, that's it for the summer. I'm done in here. I can let it rain. Let it be 110. Be back in the fall.
You get mail, Tinka?
We got mail.
Yep.
Gift for the shop.
We appreciate gifts like nothing else. That's a lot of what we get. And just be sure and contact me first. Let me know what it is if you think we may or may not be able to use it. And I'll let you know, because we don't want to end up with stuff that we really can't put to use. This, we can put to use. This is a mister system. That'll help keep our tools cool on the Tormach. And, oh, that's wonderful. And it has a spray attachment and everything.
Lovely, just lovely. Because I think we will be the only Chinese junk out there on the ocean with a Tormach mill on board.
So for this, I thank Mr. Bears in Traverse City, Michigan. Love ya. This is really appreciated.
That's as close as I dare get. Now, I bet there's guys out there that could use that table saw and even do this cut with it, but I'm not that guy. And it's important that I think you remember about what kind of guy you are. Trust yourself. Stay in your limits. And safely explore your limits. There's enough cowards sitting at home doing nothing, just saying, ah, that's dangerous. Don't listen to them. Go out and see if it is dangerous. There we go.
I had some leftover UHMW stock. It's a really high density plastic. And cutting it into some washers for the chain locker.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
Now there they are, two chain stoppers. This will still need some more work. I gotta get these bent, and they gotta move a little easier than that, so they come over each piece of chain. And might have to notch the back side of them because the chain's gonna hit that. Should have offset this plate,
That'd be another option too, is cut that away and move it down lower on this 2-inch.
Because if you look right underneath it, you see by the time you see that groove, you probably need a little bit of groove here. You know what, we'll just see how it works, then we'll take a grinder to it or fix it then.
Wind's blowing at 12 miles an hour, which is pretty fast for August, and that's my neighbor over there.
Paul Nosack. Nice to have friends with big toys.
Kibbles. Shit. Ah. What?
Pearl. I mean the pearl or the It'll come across the hatch.
Okay.
3.7 pounds.
Wow.
Now it's time to go the other way.
Cummins 5.9 diesel engine, and every 2-3 months we come out and start it up. It's to keep it in healthy shape, keeps everything oiled, I think, is what it is.
Now, if you're the sort of person that's really cautious, don't use PVC pipe for your high-pressure airline. If you're the sort of person that has made pipe bombs out of this stuff, not saying anything, you'll know that if it does fracture and explode, it decelerates really quickly because it just doesn't have much mass, so there's nearly not much to worry about. And you're probably not the sort of person that ought to be building a boat to sail in the oceans anyway.
I used to put in lawn sprinkler systems to help pay my way through college, and one thing I learned off that job was to tape my glue and cleaner cans together. That way they both follow you around wherever you go.
I haven't used PEX yet, but that's probably what we're going to use on the boat. It just looks even easier than PVC.
What would life be without baling wire and duct tape?
This one you're looking for, right?
The needle valve.
Yeah,
put more in it.
Stick it on wherever we want.
And then we change the air volume on it too.
Pressure regulator?
Yeah, pressure regulator on it. Well, we're using Cool Mist. It's expensive, but it dilutes only 4 ounces to a gallon.
Well, next up is the ROV and sails. We've got both those things coming along, and I really do need to get on the ROV. It's one of those things, though, once I get started on it, I have to really stay on it. No interruptions, or I forget where I was. And I gotta say a huge thank you for you guys out there. 170 of you now are patrons for SV Seeker, and we appreciate that. $479 a month for us just doing what we do anyway. I love you for it. We're going to be buying a bunch of equipment and wood and stuff, insulation for the inside of the boat. Hopefully that'll come along. I think we'll be painting easily by this fall because the welding list is fairly short. So anyway, cheers. I appreciate it.